Welcome back to the Vikre Arena for the Pairs Bartending Short Program. Three pairs are competing in the finals. They will be judged on style, grace, collaboration, and technical excellence.
First behind the bar, we have Hallie Shero and Dave Marrera representing Team Cedar. Shero and Marrera are reigning national champions in Cedar, known for their enthusiastic twirling, sparkly style.
They're certainly showing that off today with this beautifully coordinated double jigger and pour. And a stir is coming up. There's the stir. Excellent. Look at the hand waving.
Oh, such artistry. All right, now they have one of their harder combos coming up. The pour and citrus peel flame will be
Whoa,
next.
Whoa, look at that Watch ice drop. That was positively glacial.
Even their ice is sparkly. Here it comes. There it is.
It looked like Marrera had a little bit of trouble on the takeoff for that flame, but landed it beautifully. I wonder what the judges will think.
For our viewers, remember that competitors are now judged on a combination of difficulty and execution, so they'll probably receive full points for difficulty for that drink, but they may get docked a tiny bit for that hiccup.
Then again, they're wearing so many sparkles, it may not even matter.
And a big start for their second drink.
No one else in bartending can execute this many twirls while adding crushed ice to a glass.
Breathtaking! A double free pour. With arms! Wow. Wow.
So good. Their final combo is coming up, a coordinated grenadine float. It's a lot
Here
of arm action there. Oh, yep. There it is.
Very nice.
A strong finish for Shero and Marrera.
Looks like the judges loved it too. Right.
What a routine.
What a routine.
And a little laughter. They're having fun out there.
Yeah. All right. The judges are coming with 8 points for difficulty, 9 points for style, for a total of 17 points.
Now, Team Juniper, represented by Caitlin Nielsen and Abigail Maliner, are taking to the bar. This is their first Ginter Olympics, and when I spoke with Maliner earlier today, it was clear the jitters were there. But they are really Juniper's darlings and are excited to represent their gin.
They've certainly started strong, a lot of confidence in that entrance.
Just a totally different feeling from the last program. Watch the timing here as Nielsen executes a bitters and muddle while Maliner free pours. Gorgeous. They came out of that perfectly in sync.
Oh, so good. Yep. And now we have their first serious combo coming up after a little bit of arm styling. They're going to have a triple ice cube toss.
Holy moly, look at
All
that.
Right, two, three, nailed it.
How perfect can you get?
Beautiful. Their signature move is coming up. They pioneered this in Ginter National Pairs Bartending. The headstand shaker hold. There you have it.
Look at their faces now.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. They are in the zone. With that trick, they're letting loose and having a good time. Finishing with a double serving pour coming up. Wow, look at that coordination.
Oh, look at that. Perfectly in sync, serving.
They are happy
with that performance.
Yes, they are. They have every right to be.
Yeah, they probably won't get full cocktail difficulty points here because they executed two shaken cocktails. But they really nailed the artistry. They nailed their combination, so they should be very happy with that.
And the judges agree. Full points for artistry and actually a solid 8 for a technical score. Total of 18 points for Team Juniper. Our last bartenders are reigning world champions and reigning Olympic champions, Chelsea Whittington and Nicholas Piscuzzi, tending for Team Spruce.
You know, they've been known for their lyrical style in the past, but for these Olympics, they've worked with a new coach and a new choreographer to completely change their style. I talked with Piscuzzi a little bit about it before today's performance, and he said that they've decided to completely focus on the drinks.
They don't care what you think. They care what you drink.
Exactly. And this is clear when you look at the cocktails they've chosen to execute. A spruce egg white sour using a reverse lime shake and a large format swizzled tiki cocktail.
Serious stuff. Look at that total focus. Whittington is starting the first half of the egg white cocktail. Look at that long pour. Piscuzzi's like one of those peeing nude baby sculptures in Italy.
I wonder if that's what they're going for. We'll find out. You can see good frothiness in the egg white cocktail already. Now watch this. She hands off to Scoozy for the reverse mime shake. And they take a dram of whiskey.
One has to admit, that's pretty badass, even at this level of competition.
There's a long shake here to get that egg white super frothy.
I do wonder, though, you know, are the judges going to like this more minimalist, hardcore style?
That
or are they
the going
to dock them points?
That is the question. They're taking a big risk here. We'll see if it pays off. Crushed ice. And coming up is their double swizzle. No one has executed a double swizzle before in Ginter Olympics bartending.
A little pause from Whittington in the setup. There it is. They did it. Man, they are starting a fire in here.
Oh, it just keeps going. Oh, yep. Look at that swizzle.
Oh, look at that. So cavalier.
They know they did it.
That is some beautifully artistic precision garnishing right there.
Watch this. They're actually going to add some cardamom pods.
Ooh, classy. Mm-hmm. Classy. You know what would make this a little better, though, is twirling. Or perhaps sparkles.
Well, they don't go for the sparkles, but they go for finishing with fire.
Oh, the smoking cinnamon stick.
And a flaming lime boat.
That is pretty fucking edgy. Wow. What is it? What is this? The closing ceremony?
A technically excellent performance with, shall we say, very avant-garde artistry. What will the judges think?
Well, we're going to find out any minute here. I'm kind of surprised, but the judges ate it up. 9 points for artistry and a perfect 10 in technical.
Whittington and Scoozy retain their title, best in the world, and they bring home the gold for Team Spruce. I am blown away by today's performers.
It was positively a sparkling, fiery, flamboyant masterpiece.
Now we know flame trumps sparkle, but just barely.
Just barely.